the problems with FIFA 20. Let's talk about it. So, this is just going to be a little bit of a video just to talk about why FIFA 20 is on a decline, really. Why, when we're all in this isolation, that it's still going down, and that really no one is playing Ultimate Team, and that everyone is just kind of switching over to either pro clubs or career mode. And the first thing I'm going to talk about is the SBCs. So, why is a 97 Messi 4.5 million coins to do? And that's if you have some of the players in there. When a Team of the Year Messi is actually around about the same price as his, look at that, 3.6 million coins, objectively cheaper than his SBC card, and you're getting a tradable Messi, his striker card, a striker Messi, 2.1 million coins, when his last SBC was 2 million coins. SBCs are way too overpriced, and just absolutely stupid. When you can buy the tradable versions for cheaper, and then if you don't like him, for some reason if you don't like playing with Messi, you could sell him. The second one, players like these, Daniel James, the only objective card that I have actually managed to grind towards, because I'm a United fan, that is literally it. But with these objective cards, my initial thought when they said, okay, we're going to release objective cards that you can start to upgrade, I was thinking, okay, cool, that means I can play games with him, start with like a 75 rated version, he gets higher and higher every game I play with him, after he scores a certain amount of goals. But no, they're making you do stuff like crosses, which you cannot do in this game unless you play squad battles, because crosses just do not work. And they're making you play stuff like squad battles. With Daniel James's card, you could have done every single game on squad battles, but you couldn't have done it on rivals. You couldn't have done every single game on rivals. A lot of them were squad battle games. And people do not like playing squad battles. It's boring. It's a grind. And that's where I'm going to talk about some of the gameplay as well. The gameplay is just a grind. The gameplay pretty much sums up FIFA. The entire game is just a grind. And you're not grinding towards good stuff. You're playing objectives. You're having to do icon objectives. See, I absolutely loved the icon SBCs they did last year, because it was something to grind towards, not grind it out. Look. Assist with a cross in 5 separate rivals matches using Bundesliga players. Rivals, that's going to take forever. It's going to be so difficult to score crosses. Look, score a volley in 3 separate squad battle matches on minimum world-class difficulty using Brazilian players. See, world-class shouldn't be that difficult. But it's the EA are just making you play game modes that you do not want to play. That's the problem with it. Look at that, assist 2 goals in 7 separate squad battle matches on world-class difficulties with 4-star skill moves and 4-star weak foot. These icon swaps. Win 4 rival matches using 9 first-time Premier League players. How are you going to get that? The only way you're going to get that is through packs. That's either packs that you grind out div rivals for, and then potentially get lucky with some good Premier League players, or it's packs that you're going to have to buy. Same with Liga, and same with Serie A, same with Bundesliga, and same with Liga. Win 5 matches using 11 first-time players. They're all packs. Win 12 foot champs games. They're making you go into foot champs, which is just sweaty. People grind for it. It's just frustrating. And then it makes you do more squad battles, which you shouldn't have to do. The only thing that EA are asking you for is to grind the game. And it's frustrating. And that's why there's such a decline. That's why people are moving on. The only good SBCs that I have loved is Leroy Sané. Look at that return. 150 goals, 128 assists, and 157 games. That's a good SBC. The player moments, they're good SBCs because they're stuff that you can grind towards. Ogbonna. Look at that. There's no date on it. There's no expiry date. See, I can understand why they do it with Messi, with Neymar. About why they have expiry dates in them. But it shouldn't be like that with the icons. The icons were a great thing to grind towards it last year. It meant that 87, 88 players were up in prices, which they should be. They shouldn't be 10k. It might sound a little bit like I might be a little bit controversial in what I'm saying, that 87 players shouldn't be 10k. That might be helpful for some of you guys, but my view is that 87, 88 players should be actually quite expensive. And what is them releasing untradeable packs of these SBCs? A lot of the packs that you get from doing SBCs are now untradeable. Look at that. You finish an 89 rated squad for an untradeable 50k pack, an untradeable 55k pack, an untradeable 50k pack as well. You only get about 130k worth of packs, and you're having to do 289 rated SBCs, 188, an 87 with a team of the week, another 87 and an 86, and you only get 135k worth of packs. In FIFA 19, if we're doing an 89 rated squad, you get an 100k pack minimum. And there's no point opening these packs anyway because you're not going to get anything good. The chances of you getting a good player is zero to none. And with this foot birthday, they could be doing so much with this foot birthday. Could be doing so much. They could be rewarding every player. People who actually... This might be the only game that they play, but they're not rewarding people. Where's the free packs this year? There's nothing. And the packs, you're getting are nothing. Look, 35k pack, just open it now. The chances of me getting a board will be quite slim. Actually one of the lucky ones this time. And I'm actually saying that's lucky to get a board. I opened a 50k pack the other day with coins that I'd saved up for some stupid reason to get absolutely nothing. To not even get a single board in the pack. And the gameplay, just to reiterate, the gameplay is toxic to play. That's why so many people are going over to pro clubs, going over to career mode, because Ultimate Team is just boring. EA needs to sort something out, and they need to sort it out fast. See, this might not be the most positive video, but trying to speak a bit of truth to EA, I think they need to realise actually how they're going to get their player base back, because no one is just playing this game. Absolutely no one is playing this game. I used to play this game quite a lot. But even in this isolation, even in this quarantine, I just have gone over to other games because there's nothing drawing me back to playing the FIFA 20. And EA needs to sort this out. And yeah, that'd be where I end the video. Cool. Thank you guys for watching. Yeah, put your views down below in the comments because it'd be great to hear them. It'd be great to hear about whether you guys enjoy the game or whether you guys have just started playing other stuff. And let me know about any other games that we can chat about.
Cool.
Thank you.